pressure to kind of carry the flag of jazz, and because it takes so much time and effort to really become a good jazz musician, I think people want to hold on to what to those things that they've worked on so much, and that they love so much about jazz. But we're products of, you know, we grew up in the 80s, and the kind of music that's around us all these days, and the access we have to different music and art experiences in general and life experiences, we feel like that has to come through in your music. Well, the concept for the new record, something we've been talking about for a long time, was collaborating with another musician. And it just seemed like a singer was the sort of the most logical thing for us to do, to kind of continue with our habit of deconstructing modern pop music.
Refashioning the music of the day as an improviser is something that is the jazz tradition. But it also goes back to classical music or anything, you know. People like Mozart and great composers, Beethoven would write theme and variations on the most popular opera and folk tunes. And it's something that I think we like listening to too, you know. It's really, it's part of the heart of jazz, really, is taking a tune you know and then improvising it. So it's perhaps less obvious to do that with a Nirvana song, but I guess we're proving that it can be done.
Now that we have a singer, everything's straightened out. We've got vocal music. It's in some ways much weirder. I mean, it's like, because she's definitely not in a red gown out front whispering everyone away. It's, she's in the mix, and it's making it even stranger to have somebody having to sing during all this madness. It's actually some of the most out music we've ever done.
Honey, I hope you can. There is something wrong with me. My mind is filled.